going on, guys? It's Beyond
the Twilight. No one can understand what you're saying on the
outro. Crash Bandicoot. Yeah, these guys are making fun of me and everything. Because, you know, they can't see you.
No, the camera's off. Yeah. He turned the camera off because he doesn't like our face.
But no, he'll be on frame.
There we go. Now we're going to more podcasts. We were just talking about that.
Welcome to Talking with the Highly Polar Friends. I did.
Wow, you just lose. You just lost.
Yeah,
you lost. Talking. Nah, I can come up with a better title.
Talking with Pizza.
No. So what's another conspiracy theory you believe in? You believe in aliens? You don't?
What?
I believe
it. No, wait, hold on. Let me hear it out.
I believe that aliens are...
No, I want to hear it.
Our fallen
hear...
angels.
What?
So I think aliens are us.
That is a plausible thing. I've heard about that. That the people from the future coming back to the past, and that's how we've evolved. Where we look like, before we have no, like, distinction and all that. That is a possible theory.
That works. Those are humans from the future.
They're humanoids from the future.
That are traveling to the past.
Yes, to spread information.
Alright, let me put this up there.
Go! Hey!
Oh shit.
We had an Akamaku.
We were talking about aliens, right? What if the Earth was flat? But the Earth is surrounded, or the Earth as we know it is surrounded by this Antarctica, if you will, right? And nobody knows what's beyond Antarctica. So what if we were just like on a plot of infinite, and once you cross Antarctica, you just travel further and further down, like, a different civilization. See what I'm saying? Maybe we're like on a big plane of ice, and that's how we reach.
You ever heard of, Flatland? It's a comical thing.
Check it out.
It's a short story, so pretty much, take one dimension, right? Can one dimension talk to two dimensions? No. So you draw a stick figure, right? And then you're a 3D person. Can a stick figure see a 3D person? No, they're just gonna hear a voice.
Yeah. Can a stick figure see a 3D person?
No, they cannot.
Why can't they?
Height and width, and then we have length. Height, width, and length is 3D. Height and width is 2D. So then, you're gonna have a person that can move left and right, up and down, but not in and out. That's 3D. Then you add linear, then you have 3D. Now, left and right. So 4D, what do you think that is? No one fucking knows. They say time is a dimension, so let's say. Yes, it's a ton. Then you start adding 5 and 6 and 7 and 8. Do you really think that's going to be something you can comprehend or something you can see? Probably not. So that's what I believe. Yes, aliens. Aliens might be people who are active enough that cross over, show themselves if they want, or not. Because the thing is, saying that life beyond us,
being so 1D, right? Like,
no, it's just being like...
Yeah.
There's multiple levels to one level.
But yeah, that
there it is.
Whoa.
So you think it's falling angles?
I think it's... What's going to...
Yeah, I want to hear it. I want to hear your theory about it. I want to hear what you think.
I go to the kind of the direction that Riv was going away. So okay, I don't know.
My name is Chris.
let me hear it. Let me hear it.
Alright, so do you guys believe this in the Bible?
I do not believe this.
I believe that those things happened, but do I believe that those things happened in the way they are portrayed? No.
Okay. So, because it goes
in. Do you know where you're going to put your beard on?
First he was like, I want to put it there, but I don't want to, like, pull and hit all the screens and stuff. And then he was like, but I can't put it on the ground because I spilled a drink already today, so I'll put it over there.
So
no,
there's
okay.
One.
Oh, wow.
I wasn't asking for it.
No, don't worry about yourself. Anyways, go back. I want to hear.
So, I believe that, if we look at technologies from the past, like the, Egyptians and the Mayans, and they all have similar structures. Even Asia.
Yes.
And they all have very, not very similar, but similar.
No, it's similar. They do the same pattern, they do the same circle within a square and all that.
So it's like, you would think, even though it's ancient times, supposedly they had primitive technology, it's like they're all in some way connected, or...
Search. I have a podcast you should listen to because it's someone who says that, like, he's been arguing there's an even more ancient civilization that I don't know about. And it has to do with that fact that a lot of ancient civilizations are connected because they have the same belief.
And it makes you think, where are they all getting?
Zero boxes. Yeah, so on the first level you destroy no boxes. The second level
you have to get to level 27.
Yeah.
Do you think at one point there were giants?
Yeah, totally.
There's like proof of it.
Yeah.
Like, but we don't ever hear about that. It's kind of like passed on. And I think that's proof of fallen angels.
Giants.
So like in the Bible and even I don't know what it's called. But it's like a...
The Quran?
I don't know what they call them. But it's... they're called Nephilim. And it's... They're like the product of fallen angels and human women.
And then, you know, you have in the Nordic culture, Nephilim.
Oh, that's what the giants were. So it's all one... So, those... They were on the
Loki is one of the frost giants, and he is the heir to Nephilim. Or is it Jotunheim? I might be mistaken, but it's one of Nephilim and Jotunheim.
It's all kind of connected in a way.
So right here, you have to jump on the one in the right there that you can hit multiple times.
Yeah.
Restart.
Just that.
Kill yourself.
I haven't hit a checkpoint. Okay, so
giants. Oh, wait, I want to hear about this giants thing, because I've never heard about.
You don't believe in giants?
I've never heard of it.
God of War.
It's one of the oldest mythologies.
Yeah, like every. So all these fairy tales or mythologies.
Medieval times.
They had to start somewhere. Like,
they're based
these off stories.
Yeah. Now, maybe it was people that. Not like 20, 30 feet giants that we're thinking. Maybe it was
like 9, 10 feet people.
Yeah, 12 foot people, like, you know, fucking walking around and
people
13
people
feet.
People call me a giant.
Yeah, you can consider me a giant if you want to.
Yeah, like. I don't know what the average height was.
They were not small. Well, we're told they were small.
Yeah, yeah, but like, you know, say there's someone like Nick walking around in medieval times. They might scare some people. They might be like, oh, he's a giant.
But, I mean, it's even proven that from like the 1950s compared to now, people have grown a few inches in average height. Like, it's just, but anyway, it's proof that giants at one point
existed.
Yeah, and then if you go into a lot of different religions, it's mentioned, and they all are kind of.
David and Goliath.
Yeah.
Torah.
It's
In the Jewish culture, David and Goliath. Literally, a small dude against a giant.
Yeah. And it said, at least in the Bible, this is where it said the giants come from. I don't know where it said they originated in all these other religions, but I don't know the issue. But it said that it's a product of human women and all the angels. And then they reproduce it. But, I don't know,
you are
helping
the Cortex gather crystals.
Like,
yet
you
have acquired
gems.
Interesting. Are you
well, Crash, know this. As long as you are allied with Cortex, you are my sworn enemy, and I will do anything in my power to stop you. If the fate of the world is truly your concern.
I believe that, like, if you believe something, you should believe it fully. So I can say I believe it fully. That being said, I would go straight to hell. But,
a lot of people who do.
Who wouldn't, is my question. Right?
All of us would.
Because you look at the text, and it's like, you can't wear two of the same, like two contradicting cloths. And you're supposed to do this, and you're supposed to do that. So, wouldn't we all...
Well, okay.
There's no one person on earth that follows it.
There's not. But a lot of that is Old Testament. So, like, when you go to New Testament...
Okay, and that's where I have the problem with every single thing.
The New Testament.
The New Testament, Old Testament, King James Version. Because it was adapted, and it was conformed. So these rulers, to whatever the fucking idea because I honestly believe that if religion wasn't made, things would be more wild and more chaotic.
I feel like
religion, but also it's a way of controlling people. Think about when you had a religion. Think about it. You had someone who said, pay your taxes, be kind to your neighbor, all that shit. Pay your taxes, like, you know.
I think these people put a lot of so if you look at, like, there's so many different denominations, but a lot of that is not in the Bible.
It's whatever person you perceive, yeah.
And it's saying, well, but people take me and choosing at that point. It's saying, I believe this part of the Bible, but not that part. Well, I think this is different. And it turns into a bunch of, which ultimately is just a bunch of man-made. Like, at the end of the day, this is what causes problems. Because people, like you said, they don't just follow. Like, if Christianity in general is just one religion, it would be different than what it is now. But now it's just rules that people made over the years that people have fought about that caused war and all kinds of other stuff. And it's, I think that's a big problem a lot of people have.
I jumped immediately. Nah, but like, you get two.
I only got one turn.
You get two now.
That's bullshit.
You get two now.
What's that bullshit?
Is this like a more advanced level?
They're all advanced.
Yeah, they can probably do it.
Nah, but like, I don't know. Myself.
Yeah.
I'm not a religious person. But Do I believe in the existence of a higher power?
Yeah.
No, he doesn't.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be.
Okay, what have we got? Someone, I forgot what his name was, but anyway, Robert Moore, he came up with Moore's Law, which means that every 10 years or so, I might be misquoting it, but something along the lines of every 10 years or so, technology is going to double computing power, and that's exactly what it's been following over 100 years. It's one of the most accurate graphs that has came out, it's one of the most accurate statements. A lot of people believe that eventually technology is going to get higher and higher and higher, that we're going to create a simulation of the universe, complete exact simulation, with people inside.
Truman Show?
A
little
bit like that. Like, have you ever played The Sims?
Oh, a little bit.
Right? What if they've made even higher graphic, higher content?
What the fuck was?
And then we're people
that don't realize we're not informed, since occasionally there's a glitch in the matrix.
If you go back on a Facebook page,
sometimes we're gonna be a glitch in the matrix.
It's the endorphins.
So it comes back to the brain and the bat argument. You have two train tracks and a train headed towards one of them. And you have the ability to control the train one of them. Do you let it run over the person? Or do you let it run over the brain and the bat that's been simulated? Have everything like a human being, so it technically is alive.
The brain.
Which life do you value less?
The brain.
Why?
Because you can see that's a human being.
But it's also a human being.
But can I fuck the brain?
It's given like chemicals and endorphins and electro.
I see you are getting the hang of it.
So I get.
I need to conserve
then
power. I will communicate with you again after you retrieve the fifth crystal.
It's the brain that can see blood. Is it murder to kill a brain? Or
Black Ops is off.
Then, see, I use that argument when talking about abortion.
I'm
approaching pro-choice. It's not my fucking choice it's not my choice to tell you whether you keep it. Because you're the one that's gonna have experience everything. You're the one that's gonna have to give up a lot of things. Go through a lot. So who am I to tell you you're going to shoot it? So it's not my decision, ultimately. But I also expect some respect. Had
like 75-25. I don't think it's like 50-50.
I can
figure
that. Yeah, I can
figure that. It's not. It's not.
Even as a woman, I think.
But that's why I said, I think it should be a conversation. And I also think the person who got you pregnant should be responsible. Because many times, I get you pregnant, I bet.
Guess what? You're stuck with a fucking kid.
Just jump on the hippo. It doesn't need a balance. That's why I'm going to go. Show me how dumb Zara.
Okay, so let's say some girl, like, just makes it a habit, which, you know, people live their lives, but she, let's say this is the fifth time, or the fifth dude she's
done. Oh, then I think she...
Like, do you think, I think there should be a limit to it. There should be no consequence. Like, I don't think you should be like, oh, I got pregnant for the seventh time, and you're gonna get my abortion.
Oh,
like,
well, then that's a conversation with the individual. Hey, have you ever heard of condoms?
But I think there should be some. Like, I think there should be trapped.
Like a stamp card? Like, you don't get something for person?
Yeah. Like, unless it, A, came from a rape, B, literally will kill you, like your body can't take it, or...
Incest.
Yeah, or incest, where the baby's probably going to be fucked up. Like...
Not probably. It is going to be.
Like, if it's just one of those two things that can be doing, like, I feel like they should be trapped, and you should be fucked up. Like... If I'm coming here for
I didn't do that.
Fucking God!
Third abortion. And none of them consisted of any of those good reasons.
I completely understand that. Also, there's stipulation for getting your tubes tied. You have to be married, you have to have, like, at some states, you have to have a girl and a boy, and all this shit.
Usually,
and also, it's easier to get your little snip undone than it is to untie tubes.
Well, I think most women have to be, yeah, they either have to have a couple kids, or they have to be at a certain age before they'll allow it, and it's, whereas dudes can still get a check.
Yeah. And, like, you're out of commission for a couple days, and then you're back. Now, back to this Fallen Angels. I think it's interesting.
I believe that. I believe that Fallen Angels
stuff like that. It's like,
so that's why if you, I think there's conspiracy about that. If you look at ancient Egypt and things like all the statues and the drawings and all those like half horse or half animal, half and you know,
yeah.
What is, maybe those were interpretations of fallen angels that were giving them technology.
Yeah,
I don't know, but it
makes sense though. I mean, gods are interpreted that way as well.
Use your
gun. I may not.
Ha! Nice. I don't know if you want to.
This is just a bonus though.
Let me show you how it's done, dude.
Is that how
just streams like water?
Yeah, mine just like
it squirts. It gets a little too excited. Not a fan of that.
Oh, you
have experience. Yeah, that's why. That's why I'm not a fan of it.
It is pee, right? I always thought that.
It is pee.
Yeah.
It comes
it's,
out of
it's,
the
yeah.
people.
Yeah.
No, that's why I'm saying I'm not a fan of it.
Yeah.
It's
that shit.
It's piss.
Like a lot. I feel so bad.
Would you sleep with someone who's been best friends?